Okay, this is a quick one. I posted this a couple days ago and had a bunch of questions on it. So I wanted to very quickly walk through a client dashboard that I've been using lately in Notion. And this is really just a simple way to not only track things like tasks, phases, meeting notes, documents, but to also make it as easy as possible for your client to track updates and to really get the most out of the dashboard so that we're making progress on projects and most importantly, not getting overwhelmed. If you're new to the channel, I'm Dave DeCespedes. I'm a certified Notion consultant and I've been working with clients for a little bit over 2 years now. I've launched over 30 Notion workspaces and building a client dashboard has been critical just to make sure that we're managing multiple projects at the same time and making sure that nothing falls through the cracks. So hopefully this is helpful. There's gonna be a link down in the description below to download the free template and there's a premium version in the Workcraft Orange if you want to support the channel, but let's dive into how it works, how the databases are set up, and what the day-to-day usage looks like. Before we jump in, I wanted to share two courses that I'm working on. First is the Workspace Builders Bootcamp, a link below if you want to sign up to know when that launches. And we're having the second cohort of our Notion Consultants Bootcamp. This is a 2-week, 6-session intensive course on everything you need to know to get up and running building your Notion consulting business. If you're interested in one of those two, go ahead and sign up using one of those links below and I'll keep you posted on when those launch and you'll get access to some pre-enrollment discounts and goodies. A couple things to note before we get started, you'll see here that there's a call out on the left-hand side and this has been really useful just in general in Notion to organize quick links to pages and then also be able to expand areas to learn more about what's going on that section or on that page. So that especially for clients, they could get a sense of what they're looking at and why it's useful. And you'll notice that each one of these also links to its own page. So if we just start with the getting started section, this is just a quick note on what to expect, how this page is laid out. If we open project progress, for example, this shows each phase of the project and the completion rate. So this is something that we'll get into a little bit more in a bit, but you could just quickly see the current phase of the project and just a nice visual marker to see where we're at. If I go into notes, this is just organizing quick notes. So if I expand this main section here, this is really just meant to be a place for clients to drop in any notes, questions, ideas, concerns. And sometimes these might turn into tasks. They might turn into documents or workflow walkthroughs, things like that. So this is really just a capture system to make sure that any ideas that come up throughout the project, you could capture them and manage them. So for example, if I open a new note here and you'll see here, it has created by and the created time automatically. So if I want to assign this to myself, I can do that and I could type in any additional notes below and that'll be saved here. And then when we decide to move that into a task or a document, we can do that and then keep this area nice and clean. So I'm gonna open this up and get a sense of where we are here. So this might be a kind of sample smaller project of identifying what are the highest priority areas to optimize in a workspace. So starting with onboarding, which is typically a week, workflow audit, understanding what does the day-to-day look like for the client and for their company before determining, hey, here are the highest priority areas that we wanna focus on in the workspace. And then getting into things like workspace mapping and subsequent sprints. So here, if I zoom out a little bit, you notice that there's a few key views and each of these views are actually referencing information from different databases. The first one is the phases of the project. So this is a nice and easy way to organize tasks by phase. And that gives us the nifty progress bar. It's essentially a roll up of what percentage of tasks are completed. So we could see here, if I open the onboarding phase, this is a relation to tasks. And I could see here progress, which is the number of tasks as a percentage completed that are related to that phase. So nice little feature there. And more often than not, clients like to see where we at in terms of a quantitative number. Meetings, this is simple list view with date and attendees. So as much as possible, templatizing things like meetings or documents. So if I open up the template here, I could see that there's just a quick section for agenda questions, meeting notes, and then a link to the task database automatically. So you could see quickly jot down additional tasks or action items from the meeting notes page. And then there's also an AI summary. So if you have the AI plan or if you have Notion AI, this automatically brings in not only the summary of the meeting, but key takeaways, additional questions. So this is updating dynamically, which is really helpful. And if we go into here and to edit property, we could see that we can create custom prompts. So if you want to format the summary in a specific way, say you want to have just a general summary followed by key takeaways and action items. Great thing about that is you could create a table view of the meeting's database and quickly reference all of this information without even opening the page. So I've been using that a lot lately in client meetings. And if we open up this left-hand side, there's also just a note on how we're using meeting notes, really just to capture those tasks and additional action items that weren't covered in the current phase or in the planning stage. Documents, this is an area where I like to add any resources or tips or later on as we get through the project, walkthrough videos to make sure that we have those all in one place. And eventually these will migrate to the client's workspace. So this is also just the kind of current system before migrating some of these larger elements to the client workspace. Tasks, as we saw before, these are also organized by phase. So we're looking at a board view that's subgrouped by phase. So you can open up a specific phase and see where are we at, what tasks are in progress, and just move them from in progress to in review to done as a standard Kanban board. And the last one, which is notes, this is just linking to any notes that we still need to process or turn into tasks or resolve. Same thing as up at the top. And if we head to the databases and pages section, always recommend having a page that's specifically for databases and higher level dashboards, mainly just to avoid the scenario of a team member accidentally deleting a database or moving it and changing the sharing and permissions. So having a databases page and having that clearly labeled just avoids that scenario. So we can see here, we've got all of our original databases formatted the same way. So this is a nice area to start building out specific views. You could grab that link and then paste it anywhere else in the dashboard. And then on the right-hand side, we've got the project hub. This is again, those specific views from different databases that we can have quick access to. And the last one is project progress. So this is really just a gallery view of phases and grabbing that task completion percentage based on how many tasks from that phase were done so far. And then one other thing to note is this is especially useful if you're on mobile, but even if you are on a desktop, any one of these, because we're linking and we're mentioning the page, we could open up this and have and go straight to the meetings database view. Also pretty helpful if we don't want to navigate to the project hub and navigate to a specific tab. We have all of these kind of shortcuts that are expandable, meaning we could learn a little bit more about what's going on in that section and jump to that specific page directly from that toggle. So that's just a quick overview of the Notion Coach client dashboard. Hope this gives you some ideas on how you might manage your client work going into next year. And if you're interested in downloading this, playing around with it, exploring a little bit more, you could download it in the link in the description below. And you can also support the channel by getting the Work in Craft Orange special version of the template, which is the one that I use. But otherwise, hope that's helpful. Sign up to learn more about one of those two courses that I mentioned earlier in the video. And otherwise, see you in the next video.